Hello everyone! How are you all doing? I hope you had a wonderful weekend. We are now back with a game called Littlewood. Littlewood is a game I've been binge playing for the past weekend. I really like it so far, and I'm ready to share some tips and tricks I learned while playing. Let's dive right in. The very first tip for Littlewood is to not spend too much time perfecting your dream layout of your perfect town just yet. And the reason for waiting a little while is because when you go into any of your townsfolk's homes and you build a desk for them, you will find that they have specific requests of where they want their homes. So it will be most likely that later on you'll have to switch around the locations so that you can meet the requirements that they like. So don't spend too much time on placement and everything yet, but you can definitely have a little fun with editing your town. The more of the requirements that you fulfill to make your villagers happy with where they're living actually gets you little gifts from them. Right over here, I have completed Dudley's request about 60%, and the more I unlock, the more gifts I will get from him, and these gifts are usually game-changing gifts. Because I've unlocked Dudley's request about 60% for his dream home, I have now gotten one of his gifts to me, which is a game-changing item. It is these jumpy boots. I can now jump up and down over elevated land, over fences, and small objects. Like so. The second tip is, don't get knocked out by spending all of your energy. So when I first started playing, I had no idea where my energy bar is, but actually it is the top bar that is filling up with EXP right on the very top. You can see that it fills up with me doing different tasks, like gardening, cooking, fishing. When you're about to get to your full bar, when you reach the very end of it and you see that there's no space left, it will tell you that you're tired and you should go home to bed. And you definitely should, otherwise you'll wake up the next day with a lot less energy. In Littlewood, they actually make it really convenient for you. There's a button that says, return home. After you click on it, you'll be sent right to your home. And then from there, you can just go to sleep. And the next morning, you'll have recovered a full bar of energy. In Littlewood, there's a lot of charming bachelors and bachelorettes, and you'll probably want to talk to all of them and get to know all of them. But the thing is, you can't be too flirty with all of them at once. You can only flirt or compliment once a day. So here, I'm gonna flirt with this guy. And then you'll see that I can no longer compliment or flirt with another person. So use your flirtations and your compliments wisely. In Littlewood, the currency is called dewdrops, and you should always try to keep some dewdrops on hand. You never know when you're gonna need some dewdrops to purchase some rare items from a special vendor that you just happened to pass by on that one lucky day. Or, on Saturdays and Sundays, in a city called Port City of DeLuca, you can purchase some rare items like plants, crops, or furniture to decorate your home or your townsfolk's homes. There is a casino in Littlewood, and it is in the oceanside city of DeLuca. When you go in, you can play the Wheel of Loot, and there are new prizes every Saturday and Sunday. And the prizes are usually very rare items. And you can only play on Saturdays or Sundays. I highly highly recommend that you go to the casino every weekend so you can maximize your chances of collecting those rare items. If you're a fan of fishing games, Littlewood does have fishing in it too. And catching fish is not too hard, but is also very fun. In order to unlock using the fishing boat, which will allow you to catch more rare fish and with a higher experience, then you'll have to reach level 30 in fishing first. You can get a boost to different skills that you want to level up quickly by visiting the coffee shop. Each kind of donut will give you a different perk to leveling up a different skill. Your first coffee of the day is also free. You don't have to pay any dewdrops for them. It is very important in Littlewood to try to talk to as much of your townsfolk as you can every single day. The townspeople that you speak to in that day will also get a boost to their experience levels, and it will raise their levels overall. If you don't talk to them in that day, then they won't get that boost. In the world of Littlewood, you don't need to use your mouse to play the game. You can use simply your keyboard and the direction keys or AWSD for directions, and you can play entirely on your keyboard alone. It is really convenient and really quick to access all keys. There's no fumbling over key controls, and it's very basic and simple. You'll have many upgrades for stores, merchants that you can upgrade with a combination of dewdrops or items and resources. I recommend you read carefully to see what each star unlocks, because for some stores, you might not need to level them up until later on so that you can save your dewdrops and your resources for leveling the more important things first. I highly recommend that you upgrade the air balloon platform first. That way, you can access all the different locations right away. The final tip is when you have unlocked the Master Forge. It is the last upgrade for the air balloon. At the Master Forge, I highly recommend that you upgrade it as quickly as you can. When you level up your Master Forge, you'll get an increased chance to get a bonus material item when crafting. And that's really important because all of the resources that you need to craft with is very rare. All of these are pretty much endgame items. So if you increase your chances of getting bonus items, then you can get more items out of the same amount of resources. In Littlewood, there are very easy and convenient buttons. These two buttons are going to help you guys save a lot of time. Those two buttons are Return to Town and Return Home. With one click of a button, you can easily return to your town without a need to access the hot air balloon that you usually need to travel with. You can also return home when you have used up all your energy on your energy bar. You should always check if you have new objects that you can build, like houses, structures, or important town objects. The earlier that you build these, the earlier that you can get the passives that come with it. Different structures have different passive bonuses. If you build them early, then you can unlock the bonuses and perks much quicker. and that way you can rack up more dewdrops and resources quickly. And that is it for my tips and tricks for Littlewood. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a little thumbs up so that I know you guys enjoyed it, and I'll love to make you guys another video like this in the future again. Also guys, I am currently on a mission to reach 1,000 subscribers. 1,000 subscribers would be a big milestone in my YouTube journey for this lovely new gaming channel. If you guys subscribe, you'll get notifications of when I post next. I currently have a schedule of posting on Tuesdays and one day of the weekend, so it'll be on Friday, Saturday, or a Sunday. If you guys want to stay tuned, please feel free to subscribe. Also, I'll be leaving my social medias right around here. You can feel free to follow me on those platforms and definitely come by and say hello. I'd love to hear from you guys. I will see you guys again very soon, and I hope you guys have a lovely rest of the week. Enjoy and happy gaming!